Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna get started with Barbara Meehan from Memphis, Tennessee, as our opening prayer. Okay,
thank you, Barbara. Okay, yes, thank you, Betty. You'll recognize this prayer as usually an after meal prayer, but it also may help us to always give thanks no matter our condition or our circumstances. We also give thanks to God for calling holy men and women to the ministerial priesthood and religious life. And we pray also that many more will answer the call. So let us begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We give you thanks, Almighty God, for all the graces and benefits we receive through you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Mary, Mother of Vocations,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph, Protector of the Holy Church,
pray for us.
Saint Junipero Serra, our patron,
pray for us.
Thank you, Barb. Thank you so much.
My name is Mori Ratuiste from Pacific Northwest, our regional director. My local club here is in Tri-Cities, Washington. Tri-Cities is composed of Pasco, Kennewick, and Richland. Richland, Washington, a significant city because it contributed to the end of World War II. That is where the atomic bomb was developed. And so the Richland football team is called the Bombers. So anyways, a little bit of history there for contribution to the World War II. So today though, what we want to focus is the important work of the programs committee. As I shared at the rally, that the main focus of the programs committee is to retain membership. And in order to do that, we ought to provide a programs that will help form our members, that will inspire them to respond and encounter Christ. Because if the program is not creating that inspiration in encountering Christ, then maybe we're just blowing in the wind. And therefore, that's why the focus of the, I will lead you later on how to access the program through the US website. But for now, I would like to share with you my screen, and we'll go with the PowerPoint presentation. As you can see in here, the BEST SERENS, and I love the acronym. And the BEST SERENS is that for us SERENS to be the best as we can, we have to believe. We have to believe in the mission of Christ. And that we continue to encounter Christ in that mission. And as we encounter Christ, then we'll be driven to share Christ in that mission. Because Christ had called us in that mission, we have to be thankful, express our gratitude to Christ for calling us to do the serious vocation of apostolates. And I tell you, the vocation of apostolate is a lifetime journey. It's not just say, oh, I like to do this for a week or two, but it's a lifetime journey. So what happens when you believe? Well, you buy into it. You have the skin in the game. You are enthusiastic about it. And you become that hot coal. You go into the direction of the possibilities and you stretch beyond what you think you can do. Or go to, you seek where and what Christ has for you, even though within your limitation. You live out, in essence, we live out the motto of St. Junipero Serra. Just imagine what St. Junipero just give up, right? Yeah, he gung-ho about it, but after he got beaten a couple of times, he gave up. California probably won't exist today, or the Serra would not increase today. And just imagine when Peter, the fisherman, left behind the biggest catch of the day. So when you believe in something, you give up for it. And how do you encounter Christ then? By being truly rooted in Christ. So your focus is, let me clear my screen here. Step back. So being truly rooted in Christ, so your focus is to glorify him. And by leading as Christ led incarnationally with a towel, not a whip at your side. You kind of like on the Last Supper, right? He washed the feet of the disciples. And by serving others and going out of your way for one another for a common goal. You know, it's kind of like Veronica. He stepped out of his comfort zone to wipe the bloody face of Jesus Christ. And then what happened to her since? He really, by praying, permitting yourself to be led by the great shepherd to be a shepherd for him. I think that's one thing that sometimes we don't allow Christ to lead us. We pray to him, but we don't permit him to answer our prayer. We find a way to answer our own prayer. And at the end, we shorted ourselves. And how do you share Christ? By building the bridges for others so they see him in you. Focus on spirituality unity. I think I like this a lot. Spiritual unity, not on personal agendas, power plays, posturing for power or control. Sometimes once we come on the leadership position, we get stuck in and the accolade of it and start to lose focus on why you are there to start with. So we share Christ unselfishly by making the best of your good resources and situations to move our vocation apostolate in the right direction as he called us. This reminded me the poor widows when she shared her sustenance, not from the excess of the gifts, but the needs, where it's hurt. It's one thing that probably as Catholic for Sarans failed to share is to share the truth, the good and the beauty of our vocations, which reflect the good, the truth, the good and beauty of our Catholic faith. Yeah, sometimes wonder why some of the Catholics are not active anymore, doesn't believe in the Holy Eucharist. And I think that because they failed to share the good, the truth and the beauty of our faith that Christ had given us. And we must do the same thing with our Sarah vocation apostolate. And lastly, we thank Christ for calling you into his vineyard to be a missionary of St. Juniperus Serra, to be a Christian, to be Christ-like. And again, if you haven't signed up on the St. Juniperus Serra missionary, I really encourage you to do so, because this is the opportunity to really be that best Serra you can be. And again, thank our membership who accompany us on this vocational apostolate. We all hear that the Christian, without Christ, I am nothing. And as a membership, without any members, we're just riding an empty ship, right? It's a lonely journey. And Sarah doesn't meant to be a lonely journey. That's why we need one another. And so when we think about being best of Sarahs, you think about the fellow members that we have and how we encounter Christ with one another. And it's hard to encounter Christ when you're all by yourself. And thus Sarah Vocation Committee really focused on what kind of program that we could provide to enhance that, to be able to form, inspire, and help our members to respond and encounter Christ in this vocation apostolate. Yes, it is very important for us to recruit members, but more important is to retain them, to make them a marathon lifetime journey of Sarans, because again, vocation is a lifetime journey. At this time, I will I will summarize this real quickly. To be the best Saran is believing in the mission that Christ has called you to, and that encountering Christ in that mission. Again, if you're not encountering Christ in that mission, maybe you don't completely believe in that mission. And when you fail to encounter Christ, you won't be sharing Christ in that mission. So this three bullet points, believing, encountering, and sharing, has to happen. If not, then the programs failed what it need to do. And lastly, thanking Christ for calling you to do the Sarah mission. And again, what's the Sarah mission? Pray for vocation, for priesthood and religious life. And the second one is helping one another to respond to the call to holiness. I always look at that, I always focus first on the call to holiness so that I can be more active in praying for vocation to religious life. Because again, we need priests to be holy, to nourish us with the Holy Eucharist. That is the end of my presentation for now, and I will entertain any question that you might have or any suggestion that you might have.
Maury, what are your suggestions for how to use this slideshow?
How to use the slideshow? Again, I will use this slideshow to in one of your meetings. And then after this slideshow, then you could show one of the missions. Since the slideshow is focused on the mission, and I think this is a good prelude to introduce the mission programs that are in our vocation manual. I mean, the program manual. I will show you how to access this manual in the website here shortly, because they will be talking about the mission and ministry of Jesus Christ, the mission and ministry of the church, the mission and ministry of the priesthood and religious life, and the mission and ministry of Sarah International, and lastly, the mission and ministry of Saint Juniphero Sarah. And so really, if you haven't have a program topics for your so far this year, I really encourage you to look this up in our Sarah International program manual is called To Holiness.
Maury, this is Candace.
Hi, Candace.
This will be going out so that this PowerPoint, so that different clubs can use this for their program meeting, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And this club could really adjust this based on the spirituality of that of each club. Based on their maturity. And it's really, really is being the best there as you can be. And that's why I said, we must believe, we must encounter, we must share Christ. Because if our vocation apostolate is not doing this, it's not helping others to encounter Christ, they're not going to share Christ. We must help them respond to that call to holiness. And just like the gospel of last week, right? How did Isaiah encounter Christ? How did St. Peter encounter Christ? And how did, yes, John. Well,
this is John. I finally got on.
Great.
I attached a text sheet that had to do with be the best Saren, and I think that if everybody looks at that, I think it expands on your slides. So if anybody was taking notes, they could refer to the attachment to the email about our meeting tonight. And one of the attachments is an expansion of your slides.
And that's very true. Yeah, I believe John Liston have included those in the email.
He did. I just remembered that. You're right. It did have a place to click on for there. And I wanted to say also, Maury, you and Kokut have a beautiful young son that's a priest. So a lot of people probably don't know that. We saw pictures
of him.
You're welcome. What is his name again?
Father Kyle Ratuiste.
Yes. Do you have a picture of him you can show everybody? The picture with the bishop that you showed us was beautiful.
Yeah, probably not in this computer that I have.
Okay.
My cell phone. He's currently with the bishop. The bishop called him the secretary cardinal. So hopefully sometimes some Bishop Daly would be cardinal. But anyway, yeah, the best sermons PowerPoint and the Word document are included in the email, and really encourage you to adapt this to your club situation. I have presented this in our club, and it really is an eye-opening. And sometimes there's some wisdom in using the acronym. So when you see the word BEST, you're starting to say, well, I must believe, I must encounter, and I must share, and I must express my gratitude to Christ to be able to be the best I can be. Not only as a Serence, but as a baptized Catholic. You know, when you called our second focus is call to holiness. Again, I just thought about this right now, being holy. Make note of this, make notes of this, because to be holy, we must have humility. We must have obedience. We must have love, and we must have Yahweh in our life. So holy. So when you think of holy, how can I be holy? Because holiness starts with humility. There are many saints in heaven, but all of them must be holy. There's no saint in heaven that is not holy. And there's no saint in heaven that is not obedience. And there's no saint in heaven that doesn't love Christ. And obviously in heaven, there is God, right? There's Yahweh. So holy, make note of that. I just thought about that.
Hey, Maury,
yes.
I just want to make a comment. Is that this, what a better time than right now for us to reset and get recharged. You know, I think it's important that we have these reminders, and it's about practicing our faith, you know, and, you know, you think about what is it that I need to do to be better, to be my best, you know, as we heard the homily this morning, it's to be the best version of yourself. So this is the best time.
And that's very good to know.
It's a great reminder.
The best version of yourself is reflecting Christ in yourself, right? If we don't have Christ in ourselves, who do we project? Whose version that we project? So the best version of ourselves is being Christ-like. And that is a lifetime journey. And I'm sure glad that I'm a Sarah member, because they, a lot of people that help fan the flame of that needs, find the flame of that hunger to be holy and pray for priestly vocation and religious life and for one another. Yeah, just like the prayer booklet that Barbara Meehan has developed, those are good things to do, good things to have on top of our reading the Bibles and the catechism. Yeah. Any other question before we move on to program manuals?
Maury, this is Shirley. I just wanted to tell you that the call to holiness that you'd recommended we use to reinvigorate our club, we started that last month.
Uh-huh.
And the handful of people that came, we still have a problem with getting people back to our meetings. But the people that were there, Sean said, this is an idea. This is what we think we're going to do for the next few months. So let's try it and tell me what you think at the end. And everybody said, this is great. This is what a meeting should be like. So we didn't have the Be the Best Sarin, which we should have had to kick off the call to holiness. So I'm going to make sure she gets a copy of that. And maybe we can go through that quickly before we move on to the mission and ministry of the church this coming Saturday. But I wanted to thank you, because I think that's right now
I don't know the person talking before, but all of our clubs seem to need a shot of energy to get moving again. And I think this is a really good program.
Thank you, Shirley. Shirley Buckmeyer is one of my district governors here in the Pacific Northwest, covering Portland area, Portland, Oregon. And she just stepped up to that role not too long ago after twisting and praying a lot, and she finally yielded. And again, thank you, Shirley, for doing that. Just a tidbit about Buckmeyer and Shirley and Jerome, her husband. They are, before COVID, they organized a vocation dinner, and they always attended by at least 400 people. And the bishop on that area and Archbishop Simple have participated on that. So hopefully we'll get back on that vocation dinner sometimes very soon, as God wills it.
Maury, did you cover the mission ministry programs?
No, I was just about ready to show that. All right, very good. This, I just type in on my browser, sarahus.org, and click on it, and this will show up in your screen. And underneath this, there is several programs you can have, but you can look on the club resources and click on the programs. There you go. And here's the meeting program called To Holiness Manual. And you click on that. And I'll just show you the manual, the table of content. And what we want to focus tonight is the mission and ministry program.
It's
located on page 6. Pardon?
There are 5 of the programs.
Great. So
there was a reason that you suggested the clubs might want to start with the mission and ministry programs in doing the Call to Holiness programs, that, you know, that would be a good place to start with the mission ministry.
Yeah.
You might want to comment on that.
And that's correct. That's why I suggested that show first the PowerPoint presentation being best sermons, and then show this mission ministry programs, so that the PowerPoint presentation and this mission ministry program will enhance with one another, because the best is focused on what is our mission. And then on this manual, again, you can click on any of this page and it will bring that one up to you. Let's just say I click on the mission ministry of Jesus and we'll bring up that page. And so there is an opening prayer, a scripture reflection, introduction, and again, the documentary tradition of that. And at the end of his talk, there is a group discussions. Like say, for example, in here, number 3, how does being a servant contribute to being a disciple of Christ? So when you look up that and when you reflect on the best presentation, he said, what is the mission of Christ? And how could I share Christ? And so, and then the next of this is the mission and ministry of the church.
And what you're showing everybody now, right now, Maury, is taken right from our Call to Holiness website with the Call to Holiness resources that are online. And these are the actual programs.
That's correct. Yeah. And so the Word document that you receive will have a suggestion how to do this. The topic 1 and 2, which is the mission and ministry of Jesus and mission and ministry of the church, you could combine those two, because they are relatively short. The number 3, I'll go back to the table content here. the mission and ministry of the priesthood You could do it by standalone, because this relatively longer than the other. And then topic number 4 and 5, the mission and ministry of SIR International and mission ministry of SIR, we could combine those, because they complement one another. And understanding the mission SIR International and mission ministry of SIR Club will help us to collaborate with one another. So that when we attend the rally, you say, well, they have the SIR International meeting and SIR USAC Council meeting, but at the end, they are one. So without the understanding of SIR International and SIR's mission, we could miss and say, oh, they're separate entity. Well, legally they're a separate entity, but in mission, they are one. Thus, the leaders of SIR USAC councils around the world become the leaders of SIR International. Again, the purpose of the program, any of these should help our members to be formed, to be inspired, so that we can respond to that call to holiness, that we encounter Christ. If any of these programs doesn't help you do that, let us know, because we're missing the point. All of this should help us encounter Christ. All of us should help us deepen our faith in Christ, our understanding of our Catholic faith. Yeah, again, if you haven't have any topics, I will strongly recommend that you start with the mission and ministry programs and focus it on the mission. And taking upon yourself, especially now that we're really focusing on the membership, St. Junipero Serra Missionary. And as a missionary, we must understand our mission. That's what we call being missionary, right? And yeah, and listening to Candace Terrell's presentation of the rally, says the importance of recruiting, of asking membership, is in the forefront. But right next to it is retaining the membership for them to be a lifetime members. We don't want them to be kind of like, we baptized them as Catholic, and then later on, where are they? So any Sarah must be an active and engaged members, but we must form them. We must inspire them, and we must help them respond and encounter Christ. I will close my mouth and entertain any question that you might have or suggestion.
Maury, will
Betty, go ahead.
Be showing the other handout that was sent. Do you have the handout?
Let me look on my email, see here.
You know, this is Judy. I'd like to mention that we have a new Lenten devotional put out for Sarah's bulletin announcements. And it's really good. And we could send that out to the people who are on. It's a beautiful, a little Lenten devotion for the bulletin that talks about vocations for each Sunday. But just make people aware of us.
Thank you, Judy. You know, we're less than 30 days away for Ash Wednesday.
Wow.
It's on March 2nd. Yes, wow.
No, that would be great. I would love to receive that.
Yes. There we go.
So this is the program suggestion.
Yeah. And Maury, can you expand it a little, zoom it out?
Yeah, let me increase this one here.
I'd like to have that also, Chuck Bellarmine. I'd like to have that also for the Baltimore Club.
Yeah, this is actually included in the email that John Liston has sent.
I think he's talking about the Lenten thing Judy mentioned.
Oh, okay.
That I'm talking about.
I'll get it to John, and he can send it out to everybody.
And again, this is the Word document that include it in the email that John has sent. If you don't have this, we could resend this one again. And again, just to reiterate, for your consideration, I started the new year with missionary of Sarah mindset by utilizing this meeting programs, Call to Holiness. And here are the five topics here. And these are the suggestion how to go about it. And again, I highlighted in here the word that I said earlier, the form inspired and responds and encounter. And then at the end, we spell fire. Really, I love acronym because when I think of fire, now I could think to myself, am I a good form? Am I inspired? Do I respond to the call to holiness? Do I encounter Christ? So when I see fire, that's on my mind. It's just kind of like the acronym that I just thought earlier, the holy. So Candace, did you take a note of that holy? What's the acronym stands for?
Fire.
No, the holy acronym.
The holy acronym.
Holy acronym. Holy,
obedience, love, and Yahweh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Obedience, love, and Yahweh. There you go. That by itself is a good program topic.
Yeah. And Yahweh.
Maury, you are the master of the MAC acronyms.
I know about that.
Yes, he is.
Holy, obedience, love, and Yahweh.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
But they don't want us to use that name for
humility, God. Humility, obedience, love, Yahweh.
Obedience, love, Yahweh.
Well, you're very inspirational, Maury, that's for sure, you know. And
yes.
It's great to have you as the core member on the programs committee. And all these documents are going to be going up on our website under the programs section. So you'll be able to download and share this with your clubs. This is very important that, you know, that we start our year this way.
No, and I just want to...
Another announcement that we need to also make is that our core committee meets every odd month to get your programs meeting put together. And so, you know, we get together for about an hour and we're able to brainstorm and we pray and, you know, we let the Holy Spirit guide us so that we can be able to provide these wonderful programs. And it's our own call to holiness. You know, it's a matter of being inspired. And like Maury said, to, you know, set ourselves on fire for the Holy Spirit. So it's important, you know, it's important for my own spirituality. So I really want to thank our core committee, Barbara from Memphis, you know, Katie from Kansas City, John Austin, Osterhart from, tell me where you're from, John Osterhart. From where?
Grand Rapids.
I knew it was Grand Rapids, but I didn't want to speak out of turn. So, and we got Maury from the Tri-Cities up in Seattle.
Well, I thank everybody for their perseverance to get on our call tonight and our
meeting.
It was, well, we'll have to find out what we have to do to avoid these problems. And anyway, I appreciate we have, you know, several more people than I expected with the difficulties we had. I appreciate the perseverance. We had one thing, Betty, that I wanted to, it was kind of designed to let you make any comments you wanted to make regarding, you know, the rally or the fact of all that we had the for our next upcoming meetings, which are every other month on even months, and they're always scheduled for the first Monday of the month unless there's some holiday or something else involved. So if anybody has any questions regarding programs at this point, this would be the time to let us know what they are. Maybe we can answer them.
John, this is Katie. I'd like to make a comment. The list of people that Betty was going over and she and John were talking about dates is that last download page and that list of downloads on the invitation.
Yep.
And it gives you all the dates for the next meetings. So the second month, the fourth month, the sixth month, etc. Every other odd, even numbered month. And you have it clear through December of this year. So.
And at this point in time, where the meetings are starting at 7:15 Central Time. And that's what we intend to keep doing unless there's a reason to change it.
I would also ask everybody who does anything with programs in a club, particularly the vice president for programs, to give us ideas about what you want to hear more about, what we can do differently, what we can do better, what we can present to you at one of these meetings. So give us ideas. Tell us what you need.
Or any things that you're using for programs that you think would be beneficial for other people to hear about. I think that, it's really important that our programs for our local clubs are interesting and valuable to their local members. It's our programs area that really retains the members once they've joined CERA.
I encourage the club president and the VP of programs to print out a copy of this. And it's rather thick, but that's a lot of...
That's called the Holiness Manual?
Right. Called the Holiness Manual. You printed that one out from the website. And I believe the Tri-Cities have probably covered about 85% of this already. Some of them are already on their second time or third time that we have presented the same topics.
I'd also remind everybody that the vice presidents of programs ought to have a copy of the program's position manual as well, that's designed for the club vice president of programs to use for his position in the local club.
This is Candace, and I just want to say that we are doing the seven serens that Judy Cousins has done throughout the United States and praying for those vocation directors. But also in our area, we're doing the Adopt a Seminarian, and the seminarians are so appreciative because so many of them are from other countries and all. And, I love CERA because you get to meet the priest, you get to do things with the priest and the seminarians, like we're going to take them out to lunch on Vu, who's from Korea, going to take him out for lunch for his birthday this month. And they just love that. And then the priest, the parochial vicar, is going to go also to lunch. So, Maury talked about call to holiness. I think being around the priest and the seminarians makes us more holy too. And I think we can make them more holy by praying for them and them seeing how we care for them. I mean, that's showing love in both ways, in both directions. And that's what Jesus is love. So I just think that these programs like Adopt a Seminarian, there's always things to do in CERA, anyone that wants to do something. So we have a poster with all our seminarians on them and that goes out to everybody. And we can get a list of all the birthdays too of all of our seminarians. So I don't know if you pass those out in your area in each of your CERA clubs. So that, you don't have to be with Adopt a Seminary, and you can know a seminarian, and you can send him a card anyway, or a Christmas card or Thanksgiving card. So I think that's the beauty of CERA.
Thank you, Candace.
Kelly, the CERA has a lot of firewood to keep the fire going. It's just a matter for you guys to pick it up and put it on. And just kind of like this manual, this loaded with good programs, it's just a matter of using it. Yeah, we just kind of like a car lot. There's the car lot is full of cars, and matter which one you want to drive. And sure. The car is not gonna run until you start the key. Get in and start the key. The same thing with these programs and the other programs that we have. The seven programs that pray for vocations, adopt seminarians, and man, a lot of fireworks to keep our party going. If they're called, they're not picking up the firewood. It's, yeah, and that's why I said, really encourage our members, probe them, thank them, and inspire them to pick up the firewood and use them and keep the flame going, because this is a lifetime journey.
That's right. And I don't want to leave sisters out too. Sisters are important too. Yeah.
And again, the missionary, yeah, the missionary that goes far away, just the thing that St. Junipero Serra is a missionary. No, man, some missionaries had hard work. Hey.
Barb, true. Do you have anything to add?
I'm good. I just love the way this meeting went. But most of all, I love the way programs intertwines membership, vocations, and communications, because it's all of that. Programs can plug into each of that. But of course, most of you know my favorite part is the prayers.
And you've done a wonderful job in designing the prayer booklets that we've...
Well, I hope that the club presidents, you know, we'll distribute those, because praying for our own apostolate is very important.
Well, thank you, Barb. You know, you mentioned all four. It's like having the four legs of a chair.
Exactly.
We need all the four legs to be able to...
Right. Remember, Sarah meets on...
Sit on that chair. So thank you for pointing that out.
Sarah meets on Saturday, remember?
Yes. Yeah, Mike Downey sent out an email this morning. So thank you. So I really want to thank everybody tonight that joined us, and something you can take back to your clubs, because I do believe that, you know, we've got to have some meat to be able to give our members. You know, we need our members, and we got to retain the ones we have. So thank you all very much.
Betty, would you lead us in a closing prayer if you can?
For persevering to being on here tonight. Yes, thank you. Going to do the prayer for the perseverance of vocations.
Betty, excuse me. Just say the closing prayer. I just want to remind you guys the three acronyms that you hear today. The best, holy, fire. Think of those best, holy fire.
Very good, Maury. Thank you, Maury.
All right. Thanks, Betty.
Thank you, Maury. This is the Perseverance of Vocations prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, you have constituted your only begotten Son, supreme and eternal priest, for the glory of your majesty and the salvation of mankind. Grant that those whom he has chosen ministers and dispensers of his mysteries may be found faithful in fulfilling the mystery they have received. Mary, Mother of Vocations,
pray for us.
Pray for us. Saint Junipero Serra,
pray for us.
Pray for us. Will you all join me with a Hail Mary tonight, please? Yeah. Hail Mary,
full of grace. Lord, is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
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 Holy Spirit.
Thank you all.
Thank you all. Good night. God bless.
It was good seeing you all. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Good night.
Good night.